To no longer offer beasts to death. festival times, but this change of thinking took place very slowly. In the 4th century, when the Romans adopted Christianity, they celebrated the birth of Christ with great processions to church on Christmas morning. The first we learn of Christmas in England was in 521 AD, when King Arthur went to York Minster to remember Christ's birthday after he had won a great battle against the Danes. And here we have Christmas morning in Rome. The second 1,000 years of Christmas. In the Middle Ages, Christmas was a very jolly time. Great feasts were held, and the stern lords of the castles gave up their places to the lords of misrule, whose job it was to play jokes on people and keep everybody merry. When Oliver Cromwell was Lord Protector of England, and there was no king, the Puritan Parliament made laws so that people would think of Christmas only as a solemn feasting were forbidden, because the Puritans said that such merrymaking had more to do with pagan sun worship than with Christ's birth. They did not believe that people could worship God by having a good time. To be fair to the Puritans, we must remember that people often behaved so badly at Christmas that they used the festival as an excuse to be hooligans. Okay. Just also say, please remember this was written 56 years ago, over half a century ago. Okay, you can imagine how many people hated the stern Puritan Christmas, and how great was the rejoicing when Charles II became king and allowed the old traditions again. The Scots disapproved of Charles II. This is why Christmas in Scotland is not the festival that it is in England. Well, I don't know. That's debatable, really, isn't it? Medieval merrymaking. Light, heat, and candles. On the shortest day, the pagan sun worshippers built fires which they thought would give the sun god strength. As the days lengthened, they rejoiced because they knew the sun god had lived through the winter and would bring them the light and heat of summer. So long before Jesus lived, fire played an important part in worship. Also, before Jesus was born, the Jews had a festival of lights in which candles were burnt. The festival was to remember the rebuilding of Solomon's temple. Were lit to show that truth was to be heard again in the temple. The light of a flame has since this time been the emblem of truth. Christians have used the flame of the candle as a sign of the truth of Jesus, and you will notice that in many churches there are always candles on the altar. There is a popular story that Martin Luther first put candles on a Christmas tree that shone above Bethlehem on the night of Christ's birth. As naked flames are dangerous in the home, we today use coloured electric lights instead of candles. Well, I'm afraid, Mr. Book, some of us still use candles. Anyway, candle flame as the emblem of truth. Christmas time in most schools and churches, children make a crib, that is, a group of statues showing all the people and animals who took part in the nativity story. This is a custom which came from Italy, and like many Christmas customs, began even before Jesus was born. For at the Roman winter festivals, clay dolls were sold in the streets of Rome to be given as presents. is full of joy and happiness. The word comes from the French carol, which was a dance, and long ago in England, this word meant a dance used to celebrate the shortest day of the year. An early history book tells that about 100 years after the death of Jesus, the Pope wanted people to sing in memory of the birth of Jesus, but the first Christian hymns were not popular because they were sung in Latin and only the priests could sing and understand them. It was at St. Francis's crib at Gracia the carols were first sung in a language that ordinary folk could understand. The actors at Gracia composed carols to sing with the play. When the service was over, the singers strolled home singing, and so street caroling began. This singing of carols in words that could easily be understood spread to other lands. In England, carols were sung by minstrels in the halls of the great lords, and later by street singers. And so today, this tradition is carried on in house-to-house caroling by groups of children and church choirs. Spirits would not die. Was called Instead. Most important festival. Christmas.